Okay, now we start the same example like before, but now we start with the DMA. Then I start new project. I will set here the F4, 401, 64-pin package, STM32F401RET. We open the project and like before, again, we select the SPI1 in full duplex. It's okay. If we look here, the PA5, PA6, PA7, everything is okay. The clock configuration, again, we can left here the 16 megahertz, but now I will use here the maximum speed because the DMA is fast, then why not? I use the 8 megahertz speed. I will check the DPI GPIO that there is the high skew rate, the high speed. Now I will enable the DMA. One DMA for transmit, second DMA for the receive. Like before, check that we have the correct directions from the memory peripheral to memory and from memory to peripheral, and also here check the increment on the memory side on the both devices. It's here. Then it looks that it's okay. Then I can here save my project. I put here the SPI3. Change my workspace to be in line with the Atolic. Okay, for Atolic, I will create the project for Two Studio. I click OK, and I will generate my code. I don't want to open, and I will open my Atolic manually. Okay, my Atolic is already open. This is good. I here only close this project from my workspace. I will import new one. My SPI3. Okay, then now it seems that I am where I want it to be. Okay, like before in UART, we can look here in the definition that there is still the same, all parameters which we wanted. In the MSP section, we have here the GPIO initialization and also the DMA initialization for the transmit and receive, also with the linking. And in the interrupt, we have here also the interrupt handlers from the DMA. Then this is perfect. And what we need to do, we only create two buffers like before. One for transmit for the deset 10 for the 10 bytes. And I will initialize the bytes. Think 69, and the second buffer for the reception. I'm missing 8 here. For the reception for the 10 bytes. Then it's okay. Then here I only call the same function like before, only with small differences, HL underscore SPI underscore transmit receive with the DMA. Again, I put the handle, it will be HSPI1. Then the data will be buffer for transmit. Then the buffer for reception, and how many bytes I want to send is 10. In the last part, again, I need to search for the callbacks. Then the callbacks will be in my drivers, in the source. Callbacks from the SPI, not the DMA, be careful. And I will search for the week. I will search for the MSP. SPNIT, DNIT, transmit, complete. And I have here transmit, receive, complete, callback. This is the my callback which I want. And I use here the same callback. And I put my famous while 1 to see what will happen if I really can get this with this speed, the old data which I am sending. Here I will change also the project settings to disable the optimization. Disable. I will save my main. I compile the application. And now I can run the debugger. I think it's okay. I put my breakpoint also here. I run the code. And I stop with the reception, then I will check my Rx buffer. That I see I received the 60, 61, 62, 63. It seems okay. And for the transmit, I have the same values here. For a check, I can restart the microcontroller. For the beginning, I here disconnect my pin from the loopback. I start it again and I will check the reception. There are only zeros. Then it seems that is working with no problems. Then now you know how to handle the USART and also with the DMAs and also the SPI in all different modes. You can decide which mode is best for you.